This is TWiT.
So is that kind of the spirit with that Hackster was born? Just kind of not trying to necessarily sell $300 boards, but really create a hacker space, more of a hacker space online?
Oh, I love that. Yeah, exactly. And the whole time we haven't been trying to make money off of the makers. Like, that's not how our model works, which is, I think, why we've managed to be so successful. So it's always been this, we used to call it the Robin Hood model, where basically we have a lot of big companies that use us, like Microsoft, Samsung, Intel, etc. And they would, for example, pay for a white label version of a page. So WindowsOnDevices.com, for example, was this thing where Microsoft had their IoT Windows 10 core, and they made a site for it, and there was a project sort of area in that site that was just Hackster with a skin on it that sort of matched their whole site lookout, so it was seamless. So they paid us for that. And, you know, for big companies where they're able to pay for, you know, running big contests and giveaways and things, paying for interview series, for example, we have a really great collaboration with Arm right now with their innovator series. So I've gotten to interview some really cool people for that. And so that's kind of like what the site has supported itself on, rather than trying to market boards specifically directly to makers. And, you know, I think we saw some companies go about it in a way that wasn't going to work super great. But then there's other companies that are coming in and doing a really great job of it. So we're still kind of in the mix there.
Well, I've been getting the Hackster IO email for maybe 8 months. I get it every day. I probably won't ever build any of this stuff. I might, but like, I just enjoy it sort of like I like looking through Instagram and just like looking at the amazing things that people do. Do you think you have a lot of audience that just sort of lurks and doesn't create? Or do you think most of your audience is people that are really going to do it?
I think both, because there's, you know, I follow a lot of like cartoonists and stuff, and I'm probably not going to become a cartoonist or anything, but I love to see that. I love to see what people are building, and it feels really inspiring. Even if I'm not going to do that direct thing, it inspires me in sort of what I'm going to be doing in a separate medium. And maybe that's sort of like what people get into. I can't look at our Twitter feed because I immediately end up with 80 tabs open, and it's a problem. But I think we do have like a ton of Facebook and Twitter followers, and a big part of what I try to do is make things that are accessible to people who don't want to spend a bajillion hours on webinars learning how to do specific things. Like there's so much about that kind of aha moment, you know, if you're able to build something in a very short amount of time. And obviously that's if you were to build something, you know. Ideally, my job would be making it much easier for you to find something that inspires you to do that and to jump off and do it. But yeah, I think we do have a lot of people who just follow us on Instagram or whatever because they like looking at cool robots. That's fine too.
Yeah. I mean, it's aspirational. I think I'm not going to say I'm never going to do it. I'm never say never. So how can people get involved with Hackster? Like, how does it work for people if they are makers or they're just lurkers like me?
Yeah, well, you can just sign up for an account. And then if you sign up for an account, then that's pretty great because you get to like stuff and bookmark stuff, and you can follow specific communities. So a lot of people are, you know, obviously Hackster is a super broad community that involves a lot of different things. And so maybe you have more specific interests like wearable tech or robotics or home automation, things that you can build that will make your office less awful. I don't know. Yours looks kind of great. And I love mine too. But, you know, that's not always the case. So, you know, whatever you're interested in, you can probably help narrow down that kind of fire hose that you see of lots of really cool stuff all the time and be like, okay, these are the things I'm interested in. Maybe like these are the specific boards that I have and I'll follow those communities. And you can really kind of drill down into what you want to find.